This is the FLSUN V400, a game changer in the 3D printing world. With its ultra-fast printing speeds and high-quality outputs, this printer is the ultimate tool for anyone looking to bring their creative ideas to life in a fast and efficient manner. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the coolest features of the V400 and give you my thoughts and experiences with this machine. Additionally, I will demonstrate how well it prints PET filament made from recycled plastic bottles. One of the standout features of the V400 is its impressive printing speed of 400 millimeters per second. This is significantly faster than most other 3D printers on the market. To put that into perspective, an 8-minute calibration cube can be printed with the same level of quality as a print that takes 30 minutes on other printers. While you can certainly print at maximum speed with the V400, it's generally a good idea to dial back some of the speed to achieve cleaner prints. The V400's direct extruder is designed to provide reliable and precise 3D printing, thanks to its dual drive gears that feed filament through the extruder evenly and securely. The extruder is also capable of printing at temperatures up to 300 degrees Celsius, which opens up the possibility of using high-temperature materials like nylon and polycarbonate. However, the PEI-coated print bed of the V400 can have difficulties with these materials, resulting in poor adhesion. The V400 boasts a spacious print area measuring 300 mm in diameter and 410 mm in height, providing ample room to work with. While Delta printers typically don't have the largest build surfaces, the V400 makes up for it in Z volume, making it a great choice for larger projects. To further reduce moving weight, the V400 uses carbon fiber for the arms that hold the print head and incorporates dual linear guides to achieve the rigidity needed for high-speed printing. The V400 utilizes linear guides instead of linear rails found on the Super Racer. According to FLSUN, this change was made for better performance. The V400 features a PEI-coated flexible spring steel print bed, which is in line with current trends in 3D printing. While the bed was one of the weaker points of the V400, I found it to be a step up from the tempered glass bed used on the Super Racer. The V400 has a 7-inch IPS display with a resolution of 1024x600 and a well-organized menu that makes it easy to use. The screen is pre-installed with Clipper firmware and can be controlled via a web browser using the mainsail OS. The moment of truth has arrived. It's time to test my pet filament from recycled plastic bottles and see how it performs in quality and speed, and if I will be able to reach speeds never seen before printing with this special filament. The first test I did with this fidget star, it was one of my first remake designed to use little filament and print fast. The speeds I used were very conservative. First, I wanted to test different temperatures during printing and see how it responded to changes. As in other printers I own, 255 degrees Celsius is still a good temperature for printing with PET filament. For a first time, I was very pleased with the result. The print was clean and fast. 50 millimeters per second is a conservative speed, but it is double the speed I use in my other printers. Then I decided to use this speed test. With it, I could increase the speed and temperature and see how it was responding to the changes. Finally, at a speed of 96 millimeters per second and 268 degrees Celsius, I was satisfied. At the moment, I am content with the fact that I am achieving 4 times faster printing speeds with my PET filament compared to other printers I've previously used. With the initial tests done, it's time to print something bigger with the new speed. This is the electronics housing for my filament machine, which uses a little more than 2 bottles. The color change from one bottle to the next can be seen on the exterior of the enclosure. After all, they are bottles, and the color changes from one to another are subtle but noticeable. PET, like PETG, is known for its poor bed adhesion. When combined with the high speeds that this printer can reach, particularly in non-printing movements, prints with little surface contact with the bed are likely to fail and detach. Even when using spray adhesive and bed temperatures of 80 degrees Celsius, this is unlikely to happen on PLA, but with PET it's a different story. However, I was able to save this failed print because the part has a uniform shape and height. A little sanding and super glue can solve the problem. Overall, the FLSUN V400 is a formidable 3D printer that boasts impressive speed, a reliable extruder, and a large build volume. While it has its quirks, like the PEI-coated spring steel print bed, the V400 delivers enviable results at high speeds, making it a great choice for those looking for a fast and versatile 3D printer. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it informative and entertaining. If you're in the market for a 3D printer, the FLSUN V400 is definitely worth checking out. I want to thank FLSUN for sending me the printer to test. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. Thanks for watching.